So our goal was to try to make it on that list, and we hoped that, you know, with your boy's support, that enough fans would call in and request our song. And we, you know, believe it or not, we had a pretty big fan base. So they were calling, they were supporting, and they were requesting our song. But the program director still, you know, didn't think it had the longevity to be on a rotation, because his words, because it was too American. So, you know, we couldn't get help from the Latino station. And then, you know, you try to go to the American station, and now you got a song that has too much Spanish in it. So they can't support it either. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, for what we were trying to do for our art, it was tough to get support on either end, because nobody is kind of willing to meet us halfway. Without radio play, no one knows about you, unless, you know, you're traveling, you're spending a lot of money trying to get out there, which we did. You know, we tried to travel, so we went to El Salvador, we went to Tulare, and these weren't even paid gigs, you know what I'm saying? This was just us hustling, just doing our thing to get our music out and show people what we could do. One of the things that we were most proud of was this contest that we performed in. It's called Tu Ciudad, Tu Música, and it's sponsored by Burger King, but more specifically by a kind of Latino movement that Burger King created. It's called Burger King Música.
Yo, la verdad, pena me da por ustedes tres, pena me da. Yo ustedes están huyendo. A ver, el ganador de esta competencia, aquí el premio, Burger King, Tu Ciudad, Tu Música es...
El hombre de la calle, 107, Nueva Univisión Radio. El ganador es...
¡JCT!
You know, the winner gets the money, the guitar, the interview, and the promotion, which is, I think, the real prize is the promotion. We won that. It was the second year. It was brought around here in the Bay Area, in Fresno. We've entered it 3 times, and we've won it. We're 1 for 3.
Well, the reason why JCT broke up, for all you fans out there still. So I put in most of the work, and I felt like I started to feel like I needed help, like they needed to step up. I started to feel like, okay, if you guys are equally as passionate about this as I am, you know, you need to step up, and because I can't do this on my own, you know what I'm saying? It's like we have a long way to go. We've got a steep hill to climb, so I need your help. And they didn't step up in my book. It was tough, man. It was tough to like push on when you felt like, when I felt like I was the only one pushing.
I was only focused on music, really, and making music and making the best music, which is maybe, sadly, the most, you know, I'm not gonna say insignificant, but you know, you can't do anything just by making music. It's not even about that. There's a lot of people out there that make horrible music, but they have great promotional skills, and that can get out there and push their stuff. And I think CT brought that to the table more than any three of us.
We just all had different responsibilities that we had to attend. At the moment, I just had my first kid, my first daughter. So it was something I needed to put my attention into. I had to look for a job, stuff like that. You know, just life in general that was happening. I think... Charlie, you know, he's married and stuff, so he had to attend his wife. John, I don't know what the fuck that nigga was doing.
There's a lot of things, there's a lot of reasons why. I think, you know, I'm going to say the biggest reason why is because of me. That's what I'm going to say. Because I don't want, you know, of course, put it on anybody else. But I didn't know where I wanted to be at that time. I didn't know what I wanted in life. I didn't know a lot of things. I was very unsure and very unstable, you know, about a lot of things.
Actually, yeah, after about a year of thinking about it, I said, okay, this is how I'm feeling. I talked to the group, we had a meeting. I said, I need you guys to do this. I need you guys to step up. If not, I'm going to be out. And it's going to suck, but, you know, I need things to change. And things didn't change, man. So, I don't know, 2 or 3 months after that, I called it quits.
And like I said, like, you know, it's cliches is hell, but, you know, if we're a trio, you know, and one gives out, then, you know, it's gonna be nearly impossible to make anything work, because you can't do anything at all. You can't perform. You can't do anything that involves a group with just two people. You can't do it correctly. You can't do it right. So, you know, if I'm not the absolute reason why, I think I was a pretty big factor of, you know, JCT's dissolvement, which, you know, I'm not gonna say was the worst thing that ever happened in our lives, but, you know, I think we would all be a little bit happier making music now. Just getting back together. That'd be cool, man. Like, I wouldn't mind it at all. I think, I don't think anybody would mind it at all, as far as me telling your CT. But, you know, definitely have to, like, you know, sit down and talk about it, you know? I'd be down with that. I'd be cool. We're all a little bit more grown, a little bit more mature. I think we would handle business a lot better. But, you know, that's just as far as I go. I'm not sure what's going on in Tony's life or in CT's life, so I couldn't say about them. Couldn't say anything about them. As far as that goes.
Pa' que sepa, JCT, sonando diferente, oye, como le gusta a la gente, esto es pa' que brinque, Jay, tell him, dile.
Se soltó el trío más heavy que viene, y echándole reggaeton para todo el que quiere, y about to get this mess fired up and cracking, wait a minute, right now, out the gate, we the best, dropping hot songs and balls like white. Pa' que sepan, todo griten huepa. Shack shit, what? Pa' que sepan.